Well, when you're at the supermarket, how do you tell the difference between what is good for you and your family and what is not so healthy?
One of the tools is the Health Star rating. The information it provides looks simple enough on the packets, but there are calls for a major shake-up of the way it operates, and there's growing concern that it just doesn't tell the full story. For more, we're joined by Linda Przedzewski from Choice. My apologies for mispronouncing that. Linda, the current Health Star rating, give us an idea of why you are concerned with that.
So the Health Star rating should be a simple system that helps you choose packaged food and drinks and differentiate between the healthy and the unhealthy products. Now, there are a few issues with the system. It's been around for 5 years, but we want to see it strengthened and expanded. That means making sure that it's mandatory, so it's compulsory for companies to put it on all of the packaged products. And we also want to see added sugars more heavily penalised. That means sugary products won't be able to get higher star ratings than they deserve.
Because the reality is not all sugars are created equal. So it's critical the Health Star rating takes into account different types of sugar, isn't it?
Absolutely. So, as you said, not all sugars are created equal. You have the naturally occurring sugars such as lactose in dairy and fructose in milk. Now, added sugars are the extra sugars that are added to products during the manufacturing process. These are exactly the sugars that the World Health Organization is telling us to cut down on.
And one of the big things that you single out is, of course, the breakfast cereal, the Nutri-Gain, the Milos and things, which they do have good star ratings on the packets themselves, but you argue that that's not necessarily reflecting what's inside.
So Choice has done some original modelling where we have tested a Health Star algorithm, but in that we've penalised added sugars. Now, what we saw was that some of the worst offenders were cereals that went from about 4 stars to 1.5 stars. That's a huge loss of 2.5 health stars, and that would make a really big difference when you're comparing products in the supermarket.
Here are some of the other biggest losers. We've just got them there. Which, as you say, I mean, that's a huge drop, isn't it? That's really worth considering when you're choosing.
Absolutely, and that's why we desperately want added sugars to be incorporated as part of the algorithm, so that these sugary products are more heavily penalised. They don't deserve these higher star ratings. We want to make sure that they're getting the lower star ratings that they actually deserve, and that people who are shopping for packaged food and drinks have access to all of the information that they need. They deserve that transparency when they're making these choices.
So there's some of the losers, some of the ones who actually benefit from the stars. What are they?
Well, that's right. So when we tested this modelling that penalised added sugar, we actually found that some products increase their star rating because they contained less of that added sugar and only contained mostly natural sugars. Now, we've got the little snack bar that you can see there. That's received a higher rating of an extra 0.5 stars. It's still pretty low, but at the very least, it helps you compare. Mm. And similarly with the natural yogurt there, that would have an increase of half a star as well.
Yeah, okay. I reckon yogurt's an absolute minefield as well. You've been calling on the government to ramp up regulations around food manufacturing for quite some time. Do you get the impression they're now listening?
Look, it's definitely time for them to listen. As I mentioned, the Health Star rating system has been around for 5 years. It's really time to strengthen and improve the system, make sure it's mandatory, make sure that added sugars are penalised, and we also want to make sure that added sugars are clearly listed on all of the packaged foods that we buy.
Really important information. And Linda Przedzewski, thank you so much for joining
thank
us.
Thank you.
Got there in the end.
Suffice to say, we reached out to Kellogg Australia and Nestle for comment. Here's what Kellogg's had to say. No decision has been made regarding changes to the Health Star rating systems as yet. From the research we've seen, the system is working as it was designed to help consumers make healthier choices within the same food category.
And Nestle has also said that they can't comment on whether Choice's proposal accurately captures the total nutrition of a product without having the entire model reviewed by one of their dietitians. However, they say they've made a series of changes to Milo cereal, which is focused on making the overall cereal healthier while keeping the taste that people like.
Do you want to quickly respond to that, those responses from them?
Look, it's very natural for manufacturers to push back on these changes. As we know, the Health Star rating system is one that they can currently pick and choose which products they put their ratings on. What we really want to see is the system strengthened so that manufacturers can't game the system, that they can't get higher ratings that they deserve. Mm. And we want to make sure that they're not avoiding putting these Health Star ratings on some of their less healthy products as they currently are.
We'll keep up the campaign and we will keep across it as well. Linda, thank you.